You have used Durridge's capture software in order to connect to a RAD7. And now you want to use Capture's chart recorder in order to observe a measurement's progress in real time. This tutorial is going to guide you through two sections detailing chart recorder use, display and test. When you're done, you will have the knowledge and skills to run and record tests on the RAD7 through your computer. To open the chart recorder section in Capture, you need to have established a connection between your computer and RAD7. When Capture recognizes your RAD7, click the newly enabled chart recorder option on the left. See the RAD7 icon, including your unique serial number at the top, here, and watch as the computer retrieves the most recent test data on the RAD7 memory. The default view of the chart shows the latest run, with the right edge of the display representing the present moment. You can include additional data by changing the view range, but the data may take time to load, especially if you go as far back as a year. You can change the visual style of the chart using the appearance controls, which let you adjust things like the line weight and point style. By default, the chart shows radon data, but you can plot thoron, temperature, and relative humidity data by making the selections in the plot lines panel. Capture shows the different unit measurements on the right side of the chart here. You can easily see which measure corresponds to the line with the animated chart pens. You can directly control the RAD7 through Capture by using these buttons at the top of the chart recorder. You may want to log incoming RAD7 data. To do this, click Settings in the Logging panel and specify a location in which to save the data. It will be saved in the RAD7 raw data format and optionally as R7CDT data and column-based text. For column-based text, you should choose which RAD7 data properties to include by clicking Text Parameters here. When the RAD7 is set up to run the test, click the Test Start button to begin. You may hear the pump start. You can push Test Stop at any time to stop the test. You can also run a purge, access old data, and complete any other task normally carried out using the RAD7's test, data, and setup menus. The chart updates automatically every 5 minutes by retrieving the current count from the RAD7 at the given moment in time, and then drawing it onto the chart. You can update the chart at any time by clicking the Refresh Status button here. Right now, the test is measuring radon in air, but if you are measuring from water or need to configure the chart according to different parameters, you can make selections with the Chart Configuration option here. This Open in New Window button loads the retrieved data into the graph window. Note that the graph window is static and does not update in real time, but the test continues to run in the chart recorder in the background. You can analyze the data in more detail and export it in various formats from this graph window. You have used Capture's chart recorder to complete real-time analysis of RAD7 data. When you have completed the test, click the Test Stop button to shut off the RAD7 test. You have used Capture's chart recorder to complete real-time analysis of your RAD7 data. The chart recorder logs are saved on your computer's hard drive, so you can open them in the graph window at any time. For more details on using the chart recorder, you can see the corresponding section in the Capture User Manual.